Astronomers can learn about the motion of cosmic objects by looking at the way their colour changes over time, or how it differs from what we expected to see. If an object appears redder than we expected, we can conclude that it's moving away from us, and this effect is called redshift. Redshift is an example of the Doppler effect. The Doppler effect is when sound or light waves emitted by an object become squashed or stretched as the object moves towards or away from the observer. You have probably experienced this with sound. For example, when a police car drives past with its siren on, there is a noticeable change in pitch as the car approaches and then passes by. As the car moves towards the observer, the emitted sound waves in front of the car get bunched up, and the waves behind the car are stretched out. This makes the car's siren sound higher pitched as it moves towards the observer, then lower pitched as it moves away from the observer. The same thing happens with light waves. As an object moves away from us, the light waves emitted by the object are stretched out, which moves them towards the red end of the electromagnetic spectrum, where light has a longer wavelength. When an object moves towards us instead, its light waves bunch up to a shorter wavelength towards the blue end of the spectrum. This is called blueshift. Astronomers measure this redshift using a technique called spectroscopy. White light can be separated into its component colours, known as a spectrum. When a chemical element or compound shines, it has its own spectrum. Instead of a rainbow of colours, each chemical has a unique pattern of colours, called spectral lines. For an object like a star, its light will have a rainbow with extra bright spectral lines on the top. These are called emission lines. If there is a cloud of gas or dust in space between us and the star, you'll see the rainbow, but with gaps for the spectral lines. These are called absorption lines. Astronomers can compare these to the spectrum of a star and learn about the chemical composition of the star. And if the spectral lines they see in the star's spectrum are shifted compared to the same chemicals on Earth, they know the object is moving towards or away from us. Redshift and blueshift can be used to discover exoplanets using the radial velocity method. More generally, astronomers use redshift and blueshift to study objects that are moving, such as binary stars orbiting each other, the rotation of galaxies, the movement of galaxies in clusters, and even the movement of stars within our galaxy.